So we're in somewhere in Germany. It's about 19 to 23 degrees. They grow this around here. And we're about 3.5 hours away from Melt. Say that I make dance music, but most people in dance music say they make house or techno or tech house or trance or drum and bass or liquid drum and bass or something. And if we just kind of woke up tomorrow morning and there were none of these genres and you just had your record collection in front of you, you didn't know what any of it was called or where any of it came from, it wouldn't matter. That'd be great, and you'd probably write some amazing music and you'd love some music you'd never loved before, because all the connotations, all the weird ideas you have about whether it's cool and where it's come from and what scene it is and who wrote it and whether you've heard it before, those would just be gone. I like that idea. I've got one dinosaur fact. It's not even a fact, I don't think. It's just someone told me once that a dinosaur called Iguanodon got big thumbs so they could go like that, kill someone. And that's the only thing I know about dinosaurs. I haven't got a problem with them at all. I like dinosaurs, but you know, it's not like I'm a dino nerd. Looking over your shoulder, girl, thinking you should have let me have it all. I'd been doing other music and I just thought this is a stupid competitive game, this music business, and I wanted to do well in the most ridiculous situation possible, which I'm kind of in. I'm in a ridiculous situation and I like that. It's much more fun than either being in an obvious indie band or being a DJ in a t-shirt and trainers playing the top 10 biggest dance records of the moment. Yeah, I'm determined to give this a good shot because I think it would be pretty funny if I did well. I think people react quite funnily to it. Some people really embrace it and some people kind of refuse to acknowledge the full name or the costume. Some people just can't handle that I make lots of different genres of dance music. This is my dad's record label. It's 3 CDs. I used to sing in this choir. What does he do? So, conductor of a choir called New College Choir that I was in when I was 7 to 13. I travelled around playing with world-class orchestras and other conductors, and it was just an amazing way at a really young age to experience professional level music. 90% of my musical training came from those 5 years.
It's good. It's fun. Yeah, we're right next to the main stage, which is like literally right next to us. Nate's gonna go off. All that it took was one
call from his phone. I've wanted to play that festival for years, so I'm really excited. And I've got some silly shit planned. I've got some new confetti cannons. Did I only let off one confetti cannon last night? What a missed opportunity.
had another one just sat there.
About 10 minutes after I came up with the name, I kind of took it as read that obviously I had to wear a dinosaur costume. Nice fit.
So I went to the local fabric shop and got like a pattern for an animal suit, and with the help of my mum, made my first dinosaur suit. And then I got a friend involved, and that friend is Nina, and she makes dinosaur costumes, and Nina also dances for me now as well on stage with Zara, and I have two dancers on stage. And then Louisa, who sings with me on a couple of tracks. Yeah, that's the kind of live show at the moment.
Why the name, why the costume, why the dancers, why the confetti? I don't want people to see it as a kind of scary, serious project that you have to understand or know something about music to get into. And I just think it's a way of inviting people in a bit and letting their hair down.
This is a very clean version of the album Whiteboard. The album shortlist. That's not on anymore.
Nearly finished an album. I know what it's going to sound like, but I don't know how people are going to take it or whether people are going to get behind it. It's going to be all kinds of sounds and all kinds of music, kind of all electronic and dancey, but I couldn't really play you one song and say it's going to sound like this. Tried to make sure I've been slightly outside my comfort zone. The Trouble was the first song I've ever put out that's a full vocal, so I am a singer on that. It would have been much easier for me to not sing in it at all and just do a kind of instrumental banger or whatever, but something much more satisfying about putting yourself in a situation that you don't completely feel comfortable about.
That's the jazz version anyway.
One of the great things about dance music is that lyrics in dance music can be as ridiculous as you want and simple as you want and make no sense, but somehow you put a 4-4 beat behind them and repeat them 20 times, they become incredibly profound.
Like Stronger, I guess I was kind of thinking I want to do a cheesy 90s house track, something that where the lyrics are so naive that somehow they kind of take on this ridiculously profound meaning.
Feel alone in you is making me stronger.
that it's not serious, but then when you're grooving to it, it can feel quite, you know, at 3 a.m, it can feel like quite a moment.
The feel of loving you is making me stronger. But I know that heartache waits for me just around the corner.
I'm not a poet in any way. I'm not even a singer. I'm just a producer who's ended up dressing up as a dinosaur and singing.
Yeah.